Hello again and welcome to Hammer Homage. So with the release of The Hound of the Baskervilles, Hammer took a break from remaking the Universal Monster films from the 1930s and the 1940s. However, with today's film, Hammer went back to doing this and released a remake of The Mummy. It's interesting to think that the poster of the film influenced a scene in the film, but I'll discuss that in a moment. The film follows John Banning with his father Stephen and Uncle Joseph Wemple on an archaeological dig in the search for the tomb of Princess Ananke. Unfortunately, John's leg has been broken and he has to stay in a tent while the dig is continuing. Soon enough, they find the tomb, but are warned by an Egyptian not to go in or face a terrible curse. They ignore the warning, go into the tomb and discover exactly what they had been searching for. However, whilst in the tomb, Stephen awakens a mummified priest and starts the terrible curse which was warned to them. I've been meaning to watch this film for quite some time now, and to be honest with you, I was not disappointed. The first thing that really caught my eye on this was the sets, particularly when they're in the tombs. The production design and the art team really did a tremendous job on this, and I don't think those teams get enough praise. The sets were a feast for the eyes, and wherever I would look, I would see something interesting. By now you should be able to guess who our two main actors are. If you haven't, then we have Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee back once again. Hammer was like a family and liked to keep the formula the same. There are some actors who would always play the same part in films, but you would never question it. So Peter Cushing plays John Banning, and Christopher Lee plays the mummified priest Karis. Christopher Lee really uses his eyes and his hands to convey the emotions of the mummy. This is because for the whole film, he's wrapped in bandages, so he had to use what he could and it worked. When he's out for revenge, you see this in his body language as he marches towards someone and grabs them by the throat. However, when Ananke is mentioned, his eyes change from vengeful to a loving stare, and his hands change from a grip to open palms, and his arms reach out for affection. It reminds me a lot of the silent era style of acting, as you have to convey everything using your body. You remember at the start where I said the poster influenced the scene? Well, let me explain. The poster for The Mummy was made before the film was finished, and it shows a glorious image of a light shining through the mummy's body. Peter Cushing saw this and realised there was nothing in the film which demonstrated this, and he knew people would want to see this. So, a compromise was made. And in a scene involving John Banning and Karis, John stabs Karis straight through with a spear, and the mummy continues to fight John. So this film is a feast for the eyes with some silent era acting thrown in. So it's a win-win all round, and I can't believe it's taken me this long to see it. So go check it out, I guarantee you won't be disappointed.